للي عايشين بره. بدك تست تاني؟ اوكي ثانك يو. Good morning.
شو اسم البنت اللي عم هي بتشوف الميلات عندك وكذا؟ شو اسمها؟
ماري سقر. ماري more tired than usual today, eh? You are more tired than usual. Tired? No?
Tired.
لقيته بيرفادي ما
عادي لانتي.
سمر سمر بليز بتعيطي للباقيين يفوتوا. تاخرنا على بير لويس.
معلش
خليش معلش يكونوا لازم يكونوا هون التايم
يكونوا مرتاحين.
وينهم؟ بعدهم نامي؟ وينهم هلا؟
Bonjour, good morning.
Bonjour.
سورة العيلة. بدك اياني اوقف ولا هيك؟ خدي واحدة تانية بعد. حلوة. Thank you. What's your name? From where? عم لبنان انت؟
Still.
one thing, we'll not wait for the others. This is Fatia Khim, our director at Tibet in Australia, is very sick today, so she canceled her lecture. Instead of Mrs. Amin Samira will give her lecture at 10 o'clock. From 11 to 12:30 before the ESL speech, we will meet in two groups. One group with Mrs. Nada Amin Samira, and the second group with Father Peace or Father Hamoun Edraous. Father Hamoun Edraous, you have met him, he was with us yesterday at Mahomet, is in charge of our offices in some countries of Latin America. We need to meet you, to talk to you about what we are expecting from you when you go back to your countries. So I need your ideas, I need your opinions about this, and I need you to convince the other to work with us. So after Mrs. Nada lecture, we'll go on two groups. One group will stay here, the second will go to the cafeteria because it's easier for you to discuss. And then 12:30 you will have lunch, or you will take your lunch with you and you will go to FSS. Regarding the graduation on the 16th, we have a little problem. We have all the group, and I will be with you. We should be at PL, we should be here at 4 o'clock in the afternoon. The problem is major for the girls, for your hair, for your makeup. So we have two conferences, one at 10, and it's very important. Again, especially from London, and you will discover this yourself. And the second speaker is the son of the Shwele, who they organized for this. So we have two lectures, we'll finish at 12. You have just 3 hours, girls, to get ready for the graduation. I'm sorry to tell you this, you have to manage maybe, you have to prepare some of your stuff for on Friday evening. You manage for this, to organize your gala dinner. Friday evening, we plan to go, Friday afternoon, we plan to go to Biblos, and we plan to have a big party there. I don't think we'll be able if you have to get up early and to fix your things for the gala dinner. Few of you should leave on the 17th very early in the morning. Their flights are very, very early in the morning. They have to pack their luggage and take them with you. You take your luggage in the bus with you to Biel, because I ordered a taxi to come from to pick you up from Biel. So take care of this, you will not have time to come back here. Otherwise you will miss your flight. Please organize yourself well, because we don't have any more time and we need to talk and to talk and to discuss with you and to know your opinions about this experience. For me it was a beautiful experience. I hope it is for you. We still have 3-4 days. You will enjoy tomorrow Dimen. Another thing I have to tell you about the men, you have to wear, to be with decent clothes, and shorts for the girls, you have to forget about the shorts for the men. You can pack a small short if you want to change there after the men. We'll go to Addis, to the Cedars, we'll have the chance to sleep at the Cedars, and we'll not come back here tomorrow. So Wednesday, we'll sleep in the north. You have to organize yourselves for this too. So please, I couldn't believe that they will let us sleep with the army. It's a beautiful hotel for the army, so you will be really very well. It's a beautiful, beautiful one. So you will meet the chief of the station there, and he will explain a little bit about the army and about the mission of the Lebanese army. Do you
take blankets?
No, everything is, no. You take just a jacket because it is very, very, very cold at night there. A sweatshirt or a jacket or a, yes.
So some of us have a flight at 11 a.m. on Sunday.
You are leaving at what time?
11 a.m.
11? 11?
that time, so you come back here.
We come back.
And the taxi will pick up from here.
Yeah, we're going to come back here.
Okay. Only those who should leave around 2-3 a.m., 2 or 3 a.m., and you are many. Maybe from Latin America, you are many too. Yeah, I know, because I am preparing the list for the taxi. Don't worry, everything is organized, but I need you to organize your things, okay? So I'm sorry, Father. I don't need to introduce, you know him already. He has been with us for a few days, and he is in charge of the Office of Immigration with the Patriarch in Yemen and in Turkey. Mr. Abuna Luis Al-Farakh is from Yuzek congregation, is a monk of the Lebanese congregation. Lebanese Maronite Order. Okay.
Well, good morning to everyone. Buenos dias a todos ustedes. Bon dia.
Buenos dias.
My name is Father Luis. I am in charge of the office of the Global Maronite Network. I want to thank the organizer, the Maronite Foundation, for giving me the opportunity to share with you what I'm doing, my vision, my mission, my goals and activities. I also take the opportunity to thank the Maronite Foundation from the bottom of my heart for the hard work establishing offices in many cities in the world. And to thank them also for the hard work lobbying the Lebanese government, the parliament, the ministries, the interior ministry, and foreign ministry to make the process of registration easier. I take also this opportunity to thank them for preparing that highly distinguished intensive education program that would help you to be more aware of your identity, values, and traditions. I want to start with what I'm doing. This is the logo of my office, Office of the Global Maronite Network Advocate. I want to show you in what I believe. This is what I believe, that the Lebanese global presence is our presence in the world, is effective and distinguished potential power, is the preservation of the identity and the heritage, is the future of the mother church and country of origin, Lebanon, in the innovative continuity in the world. I believe also that the identity, the culture, and the heritage are a valuable trust that you are in charge of. We should preserve it and pass it on to the future generations, to you, as an icon of pride and belonging. How I work? My work is collaboration. I collaborate with the bishop and churches abroad, with foundations like the Maronite Foundation, with institutions, with association, with the clubs, and mainly with youth, with the young generations. We are today starting the sixth generation abroad. What is my vision? Is mobilizing the global Maronite communities abroad, reinforce the role of the church, and strengthen Christian presence in Lebanon and the region. What is the mission? Implement the recommendation of the Maronite Patriarchal Synod 2006 leverage the global marine potential resources, invigorate the spirit of belonging to the Maronite Church, its identity, values, and to the country of origin. Create an effective global Maronite community network. So, what are my goals? You can read it, I don't want to read everything. And this is my action plan. We will discuss it later on. This is what was about what I'm doing in the office. My first, everything has changed here. Okay. My first project. First project is iMaronite. It's a mobile application to connect all Lebanese all over the world. What is our objective of this mobile application? Embrace all Maronite around the world. Use technology as a platform to increase connectivity. Outreach, connect, and integrate the global Maronite community. Engage the Maronite in various global community current events. Reinvigorate the spirit of belonging to the Maronite Church. Involve the Maronite in global Maronite institutions and projects. Leverage the global Maronite potential resources. These are our goals. How it works? I have an application. Target audience. Everyone. From the patriarch to the young people. So, monks, nuns, clergy, monasteries, diocesan churches, institutions, foundations, courts, leagues, universities, schools, hospitals, and various association all over the world. Multi-languages, we're gonna do it in Spanish, English, and Portuguese. Okay? Push notification, you know that. So you are familiar with mobile application. Okay? Risk, security, etc. Newsletter. This is a newsletter we're gonna use. It's easy for everybody not to use his website, the priest, the bishop everywhere, so they can use this mobile application to send the newsletters. Second program is religious tourism program to Lebanon. This is meant for everybody abroad, especially Maronites, because the churches and associations, everybody wants to send groups to see Lebanon. So this is a mean that I prepare this program as tourism, religious tourism to Lebanon, to encourage family to come and visit Lebanon. This is a la carte program. These are our goals. And we have also Holy Mass, different Holy Mass in Kirki with the Patriarch. So they will attend the Mass in Kirki or in Dimen summertime with the Patriarch. They'll have coffee and chat with him after the Mass. Another Mass in Annaya, they will have a Mass and discussion with the priest, and then coffee or breakfast. In Jirakta too, they will have a Mass, the same things, in Kfifel, in Harissa too. This is the people, the group, they will choose whatever they want. They want, there is an anaya. They too, they visit Fifen. Day three, they visit where the valley of Kadisha in the north. Day four, they visit Bakdushi, etc., etc. Day five, they visit Jaita. Day six, I have 17 days. I prepare 17 days for them. Every group will choose what day they want. Okay, a la carte. And including the prices and everything. We have the prices here. And the hotel and everything. This is our second program or activity for the year to come. The third activity is this. Accredited elective courses in Yemen, something like you are doing. What I'm doing here is that the target course, the accredited elective courses are art, history, religion, music, language, and etc. They call them international liberal elective courses. The goal is to motivate the young Lebanese abroad to connect with Lebanon and increase the feeling of belonging. The target are undergraduate students, mainly of Lebanese descent, duration to 4 to 6 weeks or more to 8. Accommodation will host them with families around the university. This is very important. This program enabled so many students from all over the world to come take elective courses in Lebanon. And we host them with families around the universities. And this will help them to integrate in the Lebanese society. What I'm doing here, we have a problem, I think, that the universities, the modern university where you are registered, to allow them to come to Lebanon, not paying your tuition. This is the hard work what I do now, speak with the various universities abroad, mainly the universities where Lebanese go to, and speak with them, if you can come to Lebanon, take your elective courses without paying any tuition there. And here we'll make things easier for you. I don't want to take more time in explaining all this. If you want to, I will tell you what you are doing with ArtPost, the content of ArtPost. ArtPost. What we teach in this ArtPost, we teach folk dance, Lebanese cooking. And the other fellow, it depends on the interest of the people. We can teach Lebanese architecture, Lebanese literature, art, painters, whatever. This is the content of the art course. We have music, etc. So I don't want to take more time in explaining all this. The third is Telerimia. We are preparing a program with Telerimia in collaboration with Telerimia in Spanish and English. 3 hours per week. Friday, we will broadcast in Spanish to Latin American countries. 1 hour for the family, another hour for the youth, and the third hour is for activities. Activities in Lebanon, activities in your local community, and interview the documentary, films, whatever. In the third hour is for activities. Thursday, we'll broadcast in English to Canada, Australia, and the United States. Also the same program, English, to 1 hour for the family, youth, and activities. This is help to connect with Lebanon and to do what you are doing now, the same thing. We are also, to make the police more effective in their duties abroad, we are preparing here, like 1 year, for all the clergy who want to serve abroad. We are preparing a special program for them to learn something about leadership, about communication, about public relations, about savoir-vivre and languages. If the priest wish to work in Latin America, we'll teach him Spanish, we'll send him to some abroad, to any countries, to practice his language. Then when he will be appointed abroad, he will be more effective in his ministry. Also, to make the priest work in abroad, we'll have a workshop in Lebanon during the summer, 15 days, to come to Lebanon, the possibility to come to Lebanon for priest Maronite, serving the Maronite Church, a Catholic priest, or priest from Maronite origin who working with the Catholic Church. They have the possibility to come to Lebanon for workshops 1 week and another week to go sightseeing, just continuing education to learn about Lebanon, about our liturgy, the music, our values, and to enjoy the sightseeing of Lebanon. These are the major point that I want to speak about. My second part is this: characteristics of the global Lebanese community. This is my second part of my lecture. In this conference, I will focus on the characteristics of the global Lebanese communities. At the same time, I will identify and compare the various characteristics of the countries of destination in order to understand the environment and features of Lebanese communities all over the world, mainly grouped in regional divisions. Before, I would like to give you a quick overview of the push factors that led Lebanese to leave the country to the world. Conflicts. We have constant conflicts in Lebanon. Wars, high unemployment, education, marriage, family union, high inflation, economic crisis, and political assignments. Besides that, lack of stability, fighting for power and authority among Lebanese religious communities. General belief, a person, whether educated or not, can only improve his position by emigrating. Emigration improves a person's position of getting rich quickly before returning home. The same reason still made the young Lebanese eager to emigrate. Is that true?
Yes.
Well, I said to reach an understanding of the characteristic of the Lebanese communities abroad, we must speak about regional presence. For example, the Gulf states, Lebanese in Gulf states are different from the Lebanese who live in Western African states, different from Lebanese living in Europe, in the United States, in Canada, in Australia, in Mexico, in Central America, and South America. Every community has its own characteristics, and the features are very important, local features that influence that characteristics, the values within that country, the social cultural environment of the country, local culture, language, and other traditions, rules and regulations. These are the features that make us different for the Lebanese who live in Canada, are different from the Lebanese who live in Australia. If I want to talk with them, I must understand all these issues before I deal with them. To reach a better understanding, it is recommended to review the network which East Lebanese community abroad demonstrates, how it functions, and what are the measures that affect its characteristics. Now, I want to speak about something everybody knows. Characteristics of the Lebanese people. In general, generous in their hospitality, family-oriented, church-oriented, highly ambitious, entrepreneurial, spirited in individual initiative, and risk-takers. Moreover, contribute positively to local community, easy integrate into local society, enjoy displaying extravagant lifestyle, accumulate wealth in order to gain power, highly politically oriented, aiming to be his own boss. Also, they have large homes. Why? Lebanese in general have the tendency to live in large homes. It is a sign of stability. The people who live in Canada, Australia, and Australia, they understand what does that mean, stability in the family. Integrate and integrity and unity of the family. This is not a tradition in other Western cultures. In these homes, they enjoy various forms of entertaining for both themselves and others. Entertaining people and friends. Lebanese, I don't want to talk about that, but I think Lebanese, you are witnessing this in your home countries, and you see around you the difference. This kind of hospitality impresses others so much, it leads to mutual respect and friendship. Now, I would like to hear your contribution. If I miss something, you might tell me now, okay? What do you think, what you can add, and what do you experience in your home family? Who would like to say anything? About characteristics of the people, the Lebanese people are born to. Anything to add? Is that true?
What?
Is that true what I was saying?
Yes.
What you can add more?
We support.
Any particular characteristics?
We support each other.
We support each other. Good.
We are very warm in how we
very
talk.
Warm.
Now we call each other, we talk touch each other when in conversations. And I think Anglo-Saxons are more like reserved.
Where are you come from, Mr. Australia?
Me? Mexico.
From Mexico, good. Where do you live in Mexico?
Mexico City.
Where?
Colonia
Nápoles,
World Trade Center,
Nápoles.
Next to the World Trade Center.
I know that. I used to live in Florida.
Yeah? Nice.
What else? your partners as well.
Help and family in Lebanon. Good. And relaxes and associations. This is a tradition.
We keep our culture for the generations.
What?
We don't lose the culture that we have. Even like third or fourth generation, we keep Lebanese culture.
Great. And we keep the same accent. I forgot to mention something. We are highly connected to Lebanon. It's a characteristic. So many people, they don't have it.
So Lebanese people, it's also like in the mood for maintaining the ties between the family abroad and here. They are always interested in being connected with them. And they're also all the time ready to help you if you need anything. They are also like really helpful and really kind. They are eager to help you. They feel like they must do that.
So I want to ask another question. How do you see yourself, every one of you, is different from others? In schools, in university, or in your neighborhood? Who would tell you something? Yes.
We take our path generally, like we follow our dreams, more so than other people.
We tend not to conform as much, so we make our own rules and we follow our dreams more so than the people that are not. But
we stay at home until we're married, most of us.
What?
We stay at home until we're married. So a lot of people in Australia move out when they turn 18, without home. So I'm just saying that mostly Lebanese youth around the world still stay at home with their family until they get married, where people all around us in Australia, for example, will move out of home when they turn 18 or will be forced to find their own place or pay rent to their parents, things like that.
I will tell you what I experienced in Australia. Australian people, they are jealous of Lebanese to have big homes. They think badly how we get the money to build these big homes. I used to tell them the difference. What does that mean to us to have a home? We Lebanese, we don't go. Our parents, you go. Our parents, your ancestors, they don't go every year for holidays, to pay money for holidays. They don't go every day to eat out. So they eat at home, sacrifice. They want to bring people to their home. They do all their functions, christening. They do everything, all the parties in their homes, not abroad. This is what makes us different from other people. And one more thing I experienced in Australia too, that Italian and Greek, they love Lebanese girls. Why? There is a reason. I used to ask them, why do you like to marry? Why are you marrying a Lebanese girl? They used to say, because she treats me like a king. The way we treat the mother, the Lebanese mother, the way they treat their husbands is very important. It's a culture that we have to preserve. And I will tell you something about the Mexican girls, okay? The parents who live in Mexico City, they used to tell their girls, 18, 19, go after the Lebanese guy. Go after the Lebanese guy. Why? Because they are generous. Because they are generous and family oriented. This is very important to us. We should be proud of. Could you tell me something else about that? go ahead. You?
I think Lebanese, we have a certain pride about us where we, if we see like our sisters doing well, or our brothers doing well, or our family doing well, it's sort of, we take pride in that. We want to like, we almost feel accountable that everyone around us in our family is doing well, so we want to help them. And yeah, we sort of try to bring people up instead of putting them down, which is, I think, a bit different in the Western world of food, in the Western culture.
What else? Lebanese living in Anglo-Saxon countries, okay, Australia, Canada, United States, do they feel superior like Lebanese who live in Latin American countries? Yes. Lebanese living in Latin American country, they feel something, not superiority, something like boss. I am the boss. Because they are rich, they have their own big homes, they have everything. They feel different from other. Who will agree with me? Latin American countries. Where do you come from?
Colombia.
Colombia, yes. What's your name?
Jose Luis Calini.
Bogota?
No, yes.
Bogota. Brazil, they have the same feeling. But people in Australia and Canada, they feel different. Different approach. Similar. They cannot say I'm the boss. They cannot show off. This is a problem. They cannot show their worth. Contrary, in Latin America, they show their worth. They are proud to be Lebanese. Right? Is this the same case in Brazil?
Yes. Most Lebanese who came to Brazil, they came there like during a time in which there was like no electricity, no cities, and they really like got really rich. A lot of Lebanese.
No, it's wrong.
A lot of Lebanese in Brazil, they became really rich. Because they're hardworking people, they went to Brazil during the famine of the World War and afterwards. So they just went and worked a lot. So a lot of Lebanese people in Brazil, they're really rich. And you know, the reputation of the Lebanese in Brazil is that of people who like take really good care of their money, don't waste money. That's their reputation in Brazil. Everybody can ask any Brazilian, any non-Lebanese Brazilian, they will say that Lebanese people take really good care of their money. They don't waste it.
I want to mention something else. A tradition, generosity. Let me say this. Entertaining people at home, it means a lot. I can invite you to a big, nice, very expensive restaurant to eat abandoned food. But if I invite you to my home, it's totally different. When I invite you to my home, means you became a friend with me and with my family. This is very important. Please invite people to your home. It's very important to us. Secondly, the people, Western people, they don't have the abandoned food that we have in Mesa. They eat with worship, culture. This is for the community. That's it. In Lebanese culture, we have a plate, shot, abandoned. You can eat once, twice, three times. You can have. You can eat as much as you want, available for you. It's very important to impress people and friends, invite them to your home, and show them how important the abandoned food is. Your mother cooks, if you are five in the house, cooks for 10, for 20. This is our tradition. Well, and this is also means a lot to others. Not only friendship, means success, a key. Success to get things done for you. Everybody gives gifts or bribery, whatever. This is a kind when you invite somebody to your home and to give him tabbouleh, but to take doggy bag. Okay? This is very important. When you go to the Western family, invite you, don't take anything back with you. With the Lebanese culture, yes, you take labneh, tabbouleh, everything for you. This is very important. Use these techniques, are very important for your success, to get good friends and to impress people. Anything?
I've lived in Australia, or I was born and raised in Australia, and one big difference that I've noticed the Lebanese people in Australia have is our traditions and customs when it comes to weddings. We're very famous for our weddings because whenever you ask an Australian or anybody else to come to a Lebanese wedding, they're like, they always know that Lebanese weddings are big, fun, there's a lot of food, a lot of dance, very loud, and big drums, lots of drums. Also, when it comes to funerals, we're also known that our custom, traditions and customs in the, when it comes to funerals are different. And in general, in Australia, we also have a very famous barbecue culture. This might sound a bit strange to other people, but Australia is famous for backyard barbecues. We're also known for our big barbecues, and we've kind of got a different taste to barbecues and a different way of approaching our barbecues with the foods that we use and all the rest.
What else?
Yes. We're one of the very few cultures that combines French, English, and Arabic in, like, you know, common language, like Hai Saba or, you know, stuff like that. We combine all three languages when we're speaking. We do it like...
Say it again, baby.
We combine all three languages together, whether it's French, English, Arabic, you know, Hai Sabah or Kifi, yeah, we, like, you know, we combine so many different languages together and we do it not thinking about it. That's pretty cool. No other culture would do that.
I'll tell you my experience when I was living in Mexico City, in Colonia, Florida. And I used to invite every Thursday or Wednesday 50 people to my home. And I used to give after the Mexican people, of course, to give them tabbouleh, labneh, and shanklish. So I used to prepare tupperware, especially for them, everyone to take two or three with him, and kibinai, kibi crudo, okay, for them. They were really happy. And the next day, his wife, or he called me again, every time he called me, thank you for the tabbouleh, thank you for the labneh, thank you for the everything that they were taking from my house. It's a sign of like giving somebody $1,000 or $10,000. It's a gesture, it's very important, it means a lot to them. So I would like to encourage you to continue in this is the traditions and values that we are talking about. That we are doing all this to keep it going on around the world. Okay, I want to move to something else, to the the Vatican. Vatican is very important, Vatican II Council. They introduced in the 70s something that is very important for us as Maronites, because before you cannot establish a church. So you are Maronite, you are Catholic, so come to the corner church. Okay? Since the Vatican II, in 1970, Vatican II said, no, we want the Eastern churches, the Maronites and others, to preserve their faith, their tradition, their values. So we'll allow them to establish their churches, their organization, etc. So since that, since the 70s, the Maronites started to establish dioceses around the world and churches in every city. Along with Vatican II, and you know, especially in Australia, the multicultural policies, the government, Western government. So they introduced multicultural policies. What does it mean, multicultural policies? Multi-part society. That means you, Lebanese, you, Greek, you, Italian, or you, Chinese, or Japanese, whatever. So we all want to live in this multi-part society, and you should preserve your language, your culture, your tradition, and your faith. This is the beauty in the diversity in the society. This is very important. So why I'm saying this? I'm saying this, I want you that because the government is allowing you, the government is subsidizing your project, okay? So why we don't take advantage of this policy and to make schools, associations, take funds, whatever, to preserve our identity and to connect with them. This is why I mentioned these two, okay? The Muslim did this, the Jews did this too. And every ethnic communities in Australia, in Canada, everywhere, so they are doing the same. They profit from these policies to establish themselves, to preserve what their culture and identity. Any question about these? Is that true? Do you have it in Latin America? I don't think so. It doesn't exist. In Brazil, does it exist, this policy? Is the government subsidizing the ethnic groups?
No.
No.
Not in my country.
No. No. This leads us what? Tax detector. The system in the Anglo-Saxon countries believes that encourage people to have, encourage people to send money to different associations in your villages and whatever in Lebanon. So this is very good system that encourage you to do so. In Latin America, no. If wanna, they want to give you, take this is 2,000, 100,000, take cash. But in Anglo-Saxon countries, so it's tax deductible. So you can use this system to help association, organization, and needies in your own country. Finally, I want to speak about a plan that I am thinking to introduce it next year, to dedicate 2015, to dedicate 2015 as year of the Intishar. What does it mean, the year of Intishar? Is collaborating with different institution network all over the world, inside and outside Lebanon, and organize activities, monthly activities, What does that mean? Month one is the month of youth. So they organize, they bring youth people from different parishes and association to the level. They will, the youth group in Turkey, they will be in charge of this month. Second month, the month of the family. We have a family committee in Turkey. The family will be in charge of this month to bring people, family from all over the world, and to make conferences, activities in the world. The third month is the month of the women. The Women Association in Lebanon, Turkey, will be in charge of this month. The fourth, for the clergy working in the world abroad. Fifth is for liturgy and for the music, sacred music. Month six is tradition. Month folklore, cuisine, and different different things. Seventh is media month, advertising and media, television, etc. The eighth is for the university. The university can organize international conferences. Month nine is for month of the clubs and leagues and association. Month 10 is for cultural month. 11 is for art month. 12 for professional associations. You know that we have so many professional associations like doctors, medical doctors, lawyers, architect, and accounting, and you name them. This is the year. It could be next year or year 2016. It depends on the events in Lebanon. This is a big project, the project that helped all of us to connect with Lebanon, and to get to know everyone in Lebanon. So we encourage so many people, different, to come to this country and make activities. This is a way to encourage Lebanese to visit Lebanon. This is all the major activities that I'm preparing to launch for next year. Beside that, I prepared a course, an elective course. It's called Lebanese Presence in the World, that I introduce it to Lebanese universities. Next spring, all the students, BA bachelor students in Lebanon, are taking this course just to know what does that mean, immigration, why these Lebanese people left home, left the country, how do they live, where do they live, what is the contribution are making for the development of their own settlements in Lebanon, okay? And how we can manage to organize and motivate these potential resources that we have all over the world to help Lebanon and the church. That's all what I want to say. If you have any question, so please go ahead. Yes.
Do you have any website
where
to get more information about
that?
Do you have a website from where we can get more information about that 6 weeks courses?
I didn't hear it.
The 6 weeks courses for language and music and arts. You mentioned in the first part of our lecture. Do you have a website from where we can get more information about it?
It's her voice, right? What she's asking is about those courses that you have, the one that's 4 to 6 weeks that you can take.
Accredited, yes.
If you have a website.
Yes, yes. I want to launch everything next year. This, you're talking about this, accredited elective courses in Lebanon, right?
Yes.
Yes. next week I'm going for a trip to visit the United States, Mexico, California, Miami, Washington DC, Australia, okay, just to promote this program for next year. Yes, very important. I would like you to help me in this. It's very important to us, this program. So why it's important? Not only to come to Lebanon to take courses. The courses are motivation for you. I want something hidden objective to connect with families. For example, the families living around the university. I ask them, do you want a boy or a girl? What language? To facilitate communication at all levels. So these guys, when they come to Lebanon, take this like you are taking now, okay? And live with a family. This is a very rich experience, very important. If you have any idea to help me there to promote it, I would appreciate it. It's very important. I think I can bring thousands and thousands all year around people to come to the world. Yes.
Your mic is bad.
The iGovernment application, when will it be available?
We are planning next week we will sign the contract. And I think by Christmas, we will launch it by Christmas.
And my second question, I'm from Montreal, Canada.
From where?
Montreal, Canada. And our bishop, basically in May, we did a convention that recruited all the youth around Canada. All the Maronite youth around Canada. I was wondering if there's something similar that you could do here in Lebanon. For example, maybe bring all the youth around Canada, bring them here. I know in Australia they did something similar, so we can maybe do something.
That's why I organize next year to be the year of Intishar. Okay? Just I gave 1 month for youth, so that youth may be able to come from various countries to Lebanon and to Inshallah.
Okay. So basically something similar to the GMG that
we Yes, have. The same. What else? Any question?
Father, I want to ask you a question, so.
You can.
Now, first of all, my name is Salvador, I'm from Dominican Republic. Going back to the application, is that going to be available on all platforms? Or only iPhones, iPads, not Androids?
Yes.
Available for all platforms? Okay. And that, I mean, based on your presentation, that's something that is honestly something that we have to admire. You're taking your time, your effort, like, you know, verifying and double checking what are all the areas of opportunities to bring back the youth to Lebanon, or to at least get them involved, right? How did you come about this information? Like, to develop?
That's why we are planning so many activities, just for you.
Okay.
You move. You know what moves me to do all this? While I was living in Mexico, I went with the bishop to visit many countries, Western, many countries like Costa Rica, Colombia, Brazil, etc. Every parent used to tell me, Father, I need to find a nice boy for my girl.
Yeah.
I need to find a nice girl for my boy. That's all what they want. That's all what they want. Why? To keep on the tradition, our tradition and values. This is the hope of your parents. That's why you are here. That's why I'm doing all these activities for you, young people. You are the future. You are our future and our hope. This is why we're doing all this. Do you believe in what I'm saying?
Of course.
This is true.
Of course.
Well, now, for the English, and Spanish program with Delorean. Who would like to help us from there?
Who would like to have what?
To help us.
To help
us in these programs.
Me? Okay.
Yes.
How
this
can
is
I do
very
it?
Important to you because we want to dedicate 1 hour every week,
yeah.
Friday for Latin America, and Thursday for
U.S., Canada.
U.S., Canada, and people speak English. Who, if somebody would love to help us, okay, I'll pass on now my telephone and my email, please, to help us to contact. My name, my telephone, and my
email. Thank you.
Thank you.
Guys. Guys.
Guys.
Ladies, gentlemen. Take your seats, please. Just to remind you that you are 11. It is my pleasure to introduce to you our next speaker, Mrs. Nada Abisamla. The director of the Christian Lebanese Foundation in the World Hall, or CLFW, which was established in Washington, D.C. in November 2013 and is affiliated to the Maronite Foundation. Last year, Mrs. Abisamra played a major role in the creation of the Maronite Academy as Mr. Charles Hajj, treasurer of both the Maronite Foundation and the CLFW, said during his speech last Tuesday. She is a founding member of the Academy. Nada is currently in the final stages of completing her doctorate in education and educational technology leadership at the George Washington University in the USA. She also teaches there a graduate methods course for teachers. Ladies and gentlemen, please join me in welcoming Nada Abisamra.
Mr. Charles Hajj, Treasurer, Board Member Mrs. Rose Schwery, who will be hosting your graduation ceremony, Board Member Mr. Jack Kallassi and the whole Telelumiere team, in addition to Mrs. Hiyam Bustani, Managing Director of the Foundation, and the person who has worked the most this year, Father Jad Kusayfi, Mrs. Maria Asmar, Ms. Samar Zip, and last but especially not least, Mr. Robert Matta. Thank you for all that you have been doing for the Maronite Academy to make it a reality for the second year. I would also like to extend our deepest gratitude to Father Hadi Mahfouz, President of USAC, and all his team. Thank you for so generously hosting our students and supporting them as much as possible. Class of 2014, thank you for being here now. I know you are all exhausted. I know that. I hope you have been enjoying your time with the Academy so far. I know I have enjoyed every second I have spent sharing with you these wonderful moments in Lebanon that will become treasured memories. It is my greatest pleasure to be addressing you now. I will start with a glimpse about the Christian Lebanese Foundation in the world, elaborating on who we are, our objectives, and our three main projects. Then, I will cover some aspects of the course I taught you online about the Lebanese culture, as we can benefit from it for the purpose of registration in Lebanon, focusing on how to use our points of pride in our culture to persuade people to register, and the probable results of our success in this mission or lack thereof. Lastly, I will open the floor for any questions, insights, or suggestions you may have regarding the subject. Okay. Can I take this microphone? Can I take
it? It won't project.
Oh, it won't?
Give it a quick.
So I have to speak from here? This one? Is there any microphone I can take?
Yeah. There's a microphone.
Who are we? These are the members of our Board of Trustees. Our president is Mr. Michel Bede. Our vice president is Mr. Namat Frame. Our treasurer is Mr. Charles Hash. A member of the Board of Trustees is Mrs. Rose Schwery. Another member, Mr. Jack Kalasi. And a final, last but not least, Mr. Ramska, a member who resides in DC, in the States. We have four regional coordinators in the US. Mrs. Rula Ayid in New York, and here with us, Mrs. Josephine Sfeir Bastille, that we are very happy to have with us. We have Mrs. Natalie Marmon for Florida, in charge of Florida, yes, of course, Marmon. We have also Mr. Nana Rashid, who was supposed to be here, but maybe he thought I would be talking later. Yes, but I think you have met him. He's in charge of Ohio and Michigan. By the way, Mrs. Josephine Sfeir is also in charge of Texas, the regional coordinator for Texas as well. Where is Hannah? Hannah, yes. Okay, we have a large number of people who help us in the US. And we are also looking for adding to those members. The people from the US will be added to this list this coming year as soon as I go back to the States. We have representatives who help us collect files. We have parish coordinators who work with their parishes. We have communication specialists who help us with the database and who also help us work with the different priests who represent their bishops. We have different support committees. A religious support committee, a general support committee, a party support committee, and a marketing and media support committee. The religious support committee is formed of priests who represent the different bishops of different denominations in the US. For the Orthodox, for the Syriac Orthodox, for the Armenians, for the Melkites, and for the Maronites. And we are very happy to have with us here Father Charles Hashem. We have a general support committee. The general support committee is formed of prominent people of different denominations from different states. We want all the US to be covered and all the denominations to be covered. We have a party support committee formed of the heads or representatives of the different Lebanese parties in the US. We have a media and marketing support committee that we have just set up, in fact, and we're hoping that they will help us a lot by reviewing our website, our flyers, and helping us with the marketing of our foundation and campaigns. We have supporting Lebanese American clubs and organizations, and we work with all of them. We're very happy about that, because we believe that if all people of Lebanese descent in the country work together, then they will be successful. If only one entity works on the project, it might not be as successful. Our objectives. Register, because we are in the US, of course, we want to register all Americans of Lebanese descent in Lebanon. In different countries, you would be registering, of course, people from your country. Preserve our heritage. Preserve our pluralistic society, our confessional conviviality, and our cultural diversity. This is the most important thing for us. These three phrases just summarize everything we stand for, what we are working for. Preserve the demographic balance among the different religious communities in Lebanon.
as you can see here, these are the Maronites. Greek Catholics are here, and the orange here a little bit. The Greek Orthodox, the lighter green, and Armenian Orthodox or Catholics. We have three different projects, three main projects, in fact. Registration in Lebanon, this is only for the USA. The Lebanese citizenship petition, it is worldwide. And educational trips to Lebanon and the Maronite Academy represents them. Registration in Lebanon. The Christian Lebanese Foundation in Lebanon. And Project Roots, some of you might have heard of Project Roots that worked in the US for a few years. We are working with Project Roots, and I'm also the director of Project Roots. And all the churches, the Lebanese churches in the US, have joined the effort with the Lebanese embassy, with the consulates, with the parties, with all the Lebanese clubs and organizations in order to register free of charge all Americans of Lebanese descent in Lebanon. Everything is free of charge, of course. To launch the registration process, people can submit a request here on our website. And this is the form that they get. Or here, we have created an app for registration requests and for the Lebanese citizenship petition. I highly encourage you to download our app, if not now, maybe a little bit later, because I will reach the Lebanese citizenship petition, and to sign the petition right on the spot on this app, or through this app. You just have to type CLFW in your apps. Yes. Our campaigns. We had a pilot campaign in June, last June, which, thank goodness, turned out to be very successful. And Mrs. Josephine Sphair was in charge of Houston, Texas, and Father Charles Hashan. Oh, I cannot tell you how hard he had to work with us. Please, Father, call the priest. Please, Father, call this person. Please, Father, we need this, we need that, we need that.
Yeah.
Yeah, you will get a chance to talk about it, yeah. But don't complain too much.
Okay, then I'm not going to talk about it.
All complaints only. Okay. We're hoping to have another campaign in October. We want to plan it well and we want it to be successful. And with the help of the American students here, it will be successful. Yes? Who are the American students here? Yes. Would it be successful?
Gringos.
Yes.
Gringos,
what are you? Yes. And Salvador, you will help too. Although you're from the Dominican Republic, you have a lot of friends and relatives in Florida. We're counting on you.
Absolutely.
Officially now. Okay, Lebanese citizenship petition. I'm not perfect. Are you perfect? Or close? You're all Lebanese.
I'm Lebanese and perfect.
Lebanese and perfect. Okay. Okay. If you are of Lebanese descent, now I'm addressing you all, not only the US students. And in fact, I was also before addressing you all. You know, I was placing an ad in a magazine a few days ago. And it is thanks to you that I realized that when we address people, even if they are registered, we have to address through them all their relatives and friends, all the people on their Facebook pages, all the people on their Twitter profiles, okay? So that
you guys need to help us, even though you're not in the States. Those who are not in the States, we are also counting on you. If you talk about registration on your Facebook page and you encourage all your friends and relatives in the US to register, you give them our link, they just have to click on the link or to download the app. Click on the link, it's very easy. Fill out the registration form, it comes to us, we send it to the coordinator in the region. It takes just 2 minutes. Okay? So, for the Lebanese citizenship petition, if you are of Lebanese descent and you want your Lebanese citizenship and haven't been able to get it yet, if you believe that all people of Lebanese descent all over the world should be able to obtain their Lebanese citizenship, please sign the petition. It's very easy. You have Wi-Fi here. If not now, maybe in a few minutes before you leave today. Please make it a point to download our app, CLFW, and just sign the petition. 2 minutes of your time. We already have a large number of people. Will appear now, like 3,500 people have signed it. But it's nothing compared to what we want. We need more. We need you. We need all your friends and relatives to sign the petition. We hope by this petition to lobby the parliament to ratify the Lebanese nationality draft law, which was approved by the cabinet in December 2011. But not put to vote for vote in the parliament. Why? Why not? Parliament. We need them to sign it. We need them to ratify the law so that all the people of Lebanese descent who are eligible to register in Lebanon will be able to register in Lebanon. Sign the petition. This campaign, the Yes, I Want My Lebanese Citizenship campaign, was launched by Ms. Alamat Frame in the United States in November of 2013. So we have now 3,514 people registered until yesterday night. I'm sure now there are more. We're really marketing it well. Again? I'm bugging you, I know. But this is how we work. We have to keep on bugging. We have to keep on pushing people. If we don't push them, if we don't keep on reminding them, believe me, we have the experience as Josephine, as Father Fashan, we do not get anywhere. We do not get any results. And especially you as students, you will be bugging people. You will be bothering them. They will be telling you, just leave me alone, and you will keep on pushing them. We need to keep on pushing. Otherwise, we lose. It's a lost cause. We do not reach any. We do not get successful. Educational trips to Lebanon. This picture, these are last year's students that we are still in contact with, that we love a lot, because we bonded with them last year so much. We have a closed group on Facebook for them. And shall we open it for the new students?
Yeah.
Yes. We can open it for the new students. What do you think? The closed group? Or shall I make it public?
No, but you already have one.
You have your own groups? Not notifications. We do not notify anyone anymore. Finish. We have no more notifications. They just talk to each other. Facebook page, yeah. And maybe you can have a closed Facebook group for them, whatever. Yeah. Okay. Okay, the main objectives of the Maronite Academy that we started last year were to incite pride in your Lebanese roots, encourage you to register in Lebanon, and of course, motivate you to encourage all your friends and relatives. Okay, be proponents of registration, or as Mr. Marcel Ranem said it so well this year, and as we said it to the students last year, You need to be our ambassadors, the ambassadors of the Maronite Foundation. The word ambassador is a big word. It's not just a small word, because we really debated it last year. Should we ask them to be our ambassadors? Yes, we are asking you to be our ambassadors, officially. Not officially from me, officially from the whole foundation. Okay, join the Maronite Youth Club on Facebook. If you want to create another youth club for them this year, just let me know. How can I
help?
Not me. How can you help? We will be talking about this extensively at the end. Each one of you. So I put this here just so that you start thinking about it. How can you help? We know that some of you are students and have to go back to university, have classes, have lessons, have a hectic life, have so many things to do, but still, you need to give us how much time, Josephine?
Maybe 2-3 hours per week. It's like
2-3 hours per week. Let's start with 1 hour per week at the beginning. 1 hour per week, but one good hour per week. We're like dedicated for registration. Go on your Facebook page. Spend this hour or twice, half an hour and half an hour, just encouraging all your friends and relatives to register. Now, anything else, talking on the phone to your friends or when you see them, I'm just inciting them to register, this does not count. This is not within the hour. Okay? Okay. Lebanese culture and registration in Lebanon. This course, I gave it last year, and it was not really, it was just a bonus lesson. I say it here, I don't know if you can see it. A bonus session. For the students last year, to help them when they come to Lebanon, to help them just understand the culture. Because as some of you are very familiar with the Lebanese culture, some others are not. Who was not very familiar with the Lebanese culture before you came here, before you joined the Maronite Academy? Anyone else was not familiar with the Lebanese culture? So all of you are really immersed in the Lebanese culture? Yes? Who is really immersed in the Lebanese culture? Really immersed. You feel that you really belong, that you really know it well. Wow. Oh, look at that, Josephine. Father, a large number. Very impressed because heart of God. And this is according to traditionscustoms.com.
Do you think it does mean the heart of God?
Of course, yeah. Father said, of course, Khalif. It means the heart of God.
And it is in the heart of God.
It is.
I'm sure.
It is in the heart of God. I looked for a picture on Google to have, like, Jesus with a heart. I wanted to put the heart with Lebanon, but then I said it would be too far to explain.
That's
your imagination. Besides, they said God, not Jesus, so they would like, oh, Jesus, not God, you should have said the heart of Jesus. Okay. As Dr. Wakim said, occurrences of the name Lebanon have been found nearly 70 times in the Bible. Can you imagine 70 times in the Bible? You know, what every Christian all over the world reads, there is Lebanon mentioned 70 times. And three of the 12 tablets of the Epic of Gilgamesh. Who has studied the Epic of Gilgamesh at school? Maybe the US students or you haven't? No one has studied the Epic of Gilgamesh? Yeah, Marcel, you have. You did at ACS, the American Community School. Here, no one did? Wow. The Epic of Gilgamesh. This is a book for you to read. It's a very important book. Okay. Oh, I want to go back to this. Do you know this? Of course you know. Read that. The righteous shall flourish like the palm tree and grow like a cedar in Lebanon.
Oh, even I know.
Yeah. Okay. The Lebanese flag. You love that the white represents peace, the red, the blood that was spilled. A lot of sacrifice. When there is blood spilled, it means a lot of sacrifice. The tree means survival. We survive. We are a people that survives, a population that survives. And the cedar in the center of the Lebanese flag, the symbol of 6,000 years of history. They say 6,000 years of history. What I read was 4,000, but then here they say 6,000. Something. 2,000. Okay, Beirut, Paris of the East. You swim in the morning and then you go skiing in the afternoon. Switzerland, the financial center in the 60s. Yes, of course. But you asked, who did you ask? You guys asked Dr. Wakim a question. Okay, you're talking about a lot of things in the past. How about now? He gave you a few examples, yes. But we need more. We need more. Lebanese people to just stand out. I know. To just stand out. And we are hoping that you will. You can. If you just believe in yourselves. You know, I have a whole webpage on motivation. I'm a teacher, so I like to motivate students. Go to this page, and then after that, you really believe that you can. It's on nadasisland.com/motivation. You can stand out. We need you to stand out. Lebanon wants you to stand out. And if there is any way we can help, we will help. We will all help. Everyone here is willing to help. I'm sure Father Hashan will help. Josephine will help. Summer will help. She's already doing a lot for you guys. And all of us will help. If you need anything to stand out, create something new. We are a creative population. We are creative. And we want you to create something new. If you can create something new when it comes to registration in Lebanon, then it will be excellent. But nonetheless, just create something new. Just stand out. Okay, Biblos, you all know about Biblos, 5,000 years before Christ. Phoenicians, inventors of the alphabet. I do not want to just read them all, you know them. The Lebanese diaspora, they said before 15 million Lebanese people abroad, or people abroad of Lebanese descent. Here they say 12,369,400 people.
to Lebanon, just to register. We do not, Lebanon cannot fit them. We are not asking you to bring them physically here. Maybe for a visit, it will be perfect. But we want them to be involved in Lebanon, in every aspect in of Lebanese life. Politics, economy, social life. You can have an influence even though you are abroad. Okay. Yeah. What do you think?
No.
Yes.
You are, we are Arab.
No. Oh, wait.
Yeah.
Whether we like it or not, we are.
What?
We are Lebanese in the
Arab world. On the Maronite page, there's actually a site that says the difference between Arabs and Lebanese. We're not Arab. We're Phoenician.
Phoenician, yeah. I have it here. Phoenician, definitely. A lot of people believe that we are Phoenician. Some people believe that we are Arab. But as, I don't remember who did you ask at the beginning in one of the sessions, and he so eloquently told you that we need to define Arab. Who?
Abuna
Hadi?
Yeah.
Abuna Hadi, I think. I'm not sure. He told you we need to define Arab and then we will know if you are Arab or not. And I'm not an expert in this matter. A mosaic of closely interrelated cultures. Mahek, we are. So many cultures. Okay, the Lebanese society, diversity. We are a liberal society, we are tolerant. Women enjoy equal civil rights. No one commented on this. Did anyone comment on this and I forgot about it? Do women really enjoy equal civil rights?
Here in Lebanon.
Yeah, yeah. They say that on this website. And on Wikipedia, it's good. Yeah, they see the Lebanon as a footer. But between us, we need to know that they don't. We have a long way. Yeah.
But
still,
that's
equal is a big word. Yeah. Equal is a big word, which we are very far from.
Selectively,
yeah. Yeah. We like to claim that we are, but in fact, yeah. Okay, Lebanese customs and etiquette. We talked about it. Anything you would like to discuss? Bargaining. Have you bought anything here?
Yes.
Have you bargained?
Yes.
Yes, a lot?
For
you
years.
Have to bargain.
Yes.
Yes. If you don't bargain, you buy some things very, they would be very expensive and they should. Who has bargained? Who has any story to tell us? You have a story? Go ahead.
I went to Manny and I asked for two scoops and they told me 15,000. So I said no. And then they gave
it. They gave
it? Yes.
So what did they do?
They said, yeah, you're right, it's too expensive.
Oh.
They said, that's 50 euro.
Ooh! Good job! Yeah! Good job!
Well, I would like to discuss something.
Yes!
If you have time. We're
yes! Afraid.
We get in trouble for being late, but you guys taught us that we're late all the time.
We're just embracing it.
Oh, it's my mistake now. Now it's my mistake. I taught them that Lebanese people are late, so this is why. You know what? This is like a double thing. There are two different ways of looking at this. On the one hand, yes, we owe it to people to come on time because their time is valuable. On the other hand, unfortunately, we as Lebanese, and I am one of them, yeah, I know. Some people complain. Yeah. We got used to being like this. It's not because of a lack of respect for others. It's just you get used to it and you find so many things to do or you're too busy. But on the other hand, I know from me, I can give my time. I can give a lot of time without really looking at my watch. I can give time to people. So you see, it has its upside. But it's better not to be late.
Absolutely.
Okay? So we take the positive thing and we remove the negative thing.
Yeah.
Okay.
Absolutely.
Okay. So, did you dance any ducky yesterday?
Yeah.
Yes? Was it good?
Yeah.
And I know on Sunday we danced ducky. Did you enjoy it?
Yes.
Yes? Okay, did you see your picture at the beginning?
Yeah.
On the board? Okay, Kubesh, do you know what Kubesh is?
Yes.
Yes?
Arm wrestling.
Who does it? Who practices it?
Oh.
Not, yeah, arm wrestling.
I did it as a youngster.
As a
youngster. But I'm old now.
Okay, yeah. Okay. Who knows this? Who knows this? If we do something to keep Lebanon the way it is,
we will be honoring all our ancestors who died for us. They died for us, for Lebanon. It means for us, for you guys. This is why we need to do something, just to repay them. Any mother?
Yes.
Any here? No. No, he's not. There's another Eli. Who's the other Eli? No other Eli? You are Eli? Yeah, would you like to read something? Okay. The aspect of Lebanon of which I'm most proud is that it is a shining example to the rest of the world. It portrays the coexistence and the conviviality between Christianity and Islam. Coexisting peacefully. And better than coexisting, living with conviviality. It means really interacting with each other. Some of you also said it. Who's from Peru? I think you're the one who talked about it also. About us, you were fascinated how we live together here so well and so peacefully and with so much conviviality that this should be an example to the rest of the world. Sami Nader, Belgium, I don't think he's here either, but I love what he said. Lebanon is a country with heart. Did anyone think about this? Okay, Lebanon means the heart of God. Yeah, so it's a country with heart. We can emphasize this, focus on this. It is a country with heart, where people just give, where people give you with a lot of hospitality, with a lot of... they care about you. They just love you. Love like mahabbi. Sherbi Dumit. Sherbi Dumit. Message of freedom. My husband would have loved. He's the next general in the army, so freedom is what he fought for. Would you like to read?
But the hour has come, we need to restore balance to the Christian demography before we lose our country and all that its heroes were valiantly martyred for. Wow.
No, this is dangerous.
either not credit or.
No food is more diverse and good than the one we find in Lebanon. No party is as loud and flamboyant as the one we find in Lebanon. And every Lebanese will make it a duty to himself to introduce anybody to these jewels Lebanon has to offer. You don't believe me? Go to Lebanon and find for yourself. Go to Lebanon. Go to Lebanon.
Register to make your voice heard. If you not get involved, no one will hear your voice. You have a voice, use it. This is when I teach, you know, when I teach writing and speaking, I'm an English as a foreign language teacher, so you know, use your voice. Your voice is very important, not only in teaching writing, but even here. To affect change, also, as an Arab friend, you need to affect change. We can complain, as I told you, we can keep on complaining about what's going on in Lebanon, but complaining will not change things. We need to light a candle, I said, we need to act. This is what lighting a candle means, not just lighting a candle and waiting for it to pray. There's a saying that says, trust in God, but lock your car. Do you know it?
Yeah.
You have to lock your car as well. If you keep it unlocked and then the thief comes and steals it, then you think, God, why did you do this to me? But you didn't lock your car. So we need to act. We can pray, but we also need to act. Lebanon needs you. Why register? We are. You know, I don't know. You know, I think of the book Pride and Prejudice, and I use pride with, I mean, I'm careful when I use it. But yes, we are a proud people. We are proud, and but I think it's in the positive aspect of proud. It means we love who we are, we love Lebanon, we love the Lebanese. And we want to preserve our pride in our Lebanese roots. We want to maintain the connection of our present and future to our past, learning about our identity. Travel to Lebanon without a visa. This is why you should register, or why you should tell your friends to register. Earn the right to own property in Lebanon. Invest. Work in Lebanon. Privileges of the free trade market. I'm sure those who are in business know what they're talking about, what this is talking about. To earn the right to hold a job in the Lebanese government, you need to be registered. The right to tax exemption. To earn the right to inherit property and values. You know, the consul of Lebanon in California, Mr. John Ibrahim, you know, he introduced me, or we talked during NAM convention, the National Consulate of Maronite convention in California last March. And I talked about a lot of things, but I forgot this. Inherit property and values. And he stood in front of everyone to them. If you do not register, you will not get your inheritance. You will not inherit anything. And this kind of affects people. So use it. Use it. He's the one who pinpointed it to me. Although I had it here, but I just didn't think of using it. Okay. To maintain Lebanon as an island of democratic ideas, a message of freedom, a living example of coexistence and conviviality, and a symbol of pluralism for both the East and the West, not only for the East, and the West.
Yes.
Oh. No matter where we go, no matter how long we have been abroad, we will always remain Lebanese descendants. We will always have Lebanese roots that we need to be proud of. work hard. Look at this. Look at this. Not Canada. Not Canada. No, Joseph lives in the US. Joseph lives in California. She's in Africa. So what would we be preserving?
The balance.
The balance. And if we preserve the balance, what will be the outcome?
The voice of the people.
The voice of the people. All the people. What else?
The freedom of the Christians.
Yeah. The freedom.
If the Muslims take the government, they are going to make Lebanon.
We don't know about that, but we will be sure to preserve freedom. But there's something more important than freedom. Not more important than freedom. But even as important, what did we say our main objectives are?
Coexistence.
Conviviality. Between confessions. Confessional conviviality. And we want a pluralistic society. Because once you have a pluralistic society, once you have diversity, you have openness, you have tolerance. You have acceptance of the other. We accept each other. Why do we interact with the Muslims in Lebanon differently from the way it is done in other countries? Because we live together. We take from each other. We learn from each other. We accept and love each other. And this is what we want to preserve. I have a lot of Muslim friends, and they want the same. A large number. Shia, Sunni, no matter what. Yes. Okay. Yeah. In case of non-success, God forbid, what will happen? think the status quo would remain as is? Yeah.
So in case of non-success, you will continue to increase.
Yeah. So we are here. If we succeed, we will be here. If we don't succeed, where will we be?
On the bottom.
Here.
So we lose a lot. So we need to really work very hard. 4 million people in Lebanon, and 15 or 12 million, or even 8 million. If it's 8 abroad, still a large number. We need to work together to make it possible and easy for Lebanon's lost children to register in their country abroad. Together, we can prevail. Together, the word together. This is why in the US we realize alone as project roots. Can't do much. Together, we can do wonders. During our campaigns, we really work hard 1 month before the campaign with everyone. We involve everyone. Embassy, consulates, parties, priests, we want them all to be with us. We do not care who gets the credit, because once you start caring for the credit, you lose the cause. We care that for Lebanon, we want to be working together, all of us. And we want to make this cause a collective success. Questions? Yes?
May I have the microphone?
What?
Is there any microphone?
I can give you, do you want me to give you this one?
My name is Elihori, I'm from Brazil. Elihori. First of all, I'm honored to be here, it's a pleasure. And I fully identify with our objectives and values. I fully identify with them. But I think that besides getting people to register in Lebanon, it's as important to prevent the outflow of people from Lebanon. And so our work goes far beyond the registration and getting people to register in Lebanon. We should improve the quality of life here. We have a lot of people overseas who are full of cash and willing to invest here. We need to organize our efforts in order to do it. For an example, if you let people emigrate, those are the Lebanese, those are the really Lebanese who are living. And you have Syrians and Palestinians come, they're not Lebanese. A part of Lebanon was already lost, it doesn't come back. If you have people who have no money, they will sell their land to foreigners, they would cut our beautiful trees, destroy the old beautiful houses to make place for apartments, to rent, to foreigners as well. So that's a part of the land that's already lost. If you let people invest for foreigners, or let's say for an example, there's some controversies, okay, but in Beirut for an example. If you let the foreigners interfere with us after the Lebanese people have already left, our archaeological ruins would have already been dumped into the sea. We can't recover it. So we should improve the quality of life. Just some examples. We could set funds to invest in agriculture, village agriculture, so that these people would not have to leave Lebanon. They could stay in Lebanon, improve their competitivity. We could invest in solar power, for an example, so people wouldn't be in such need of Ishtirak and the state electricity. Just reduce the factors that drive the outflow of people. I think it's equally important.
Thank you so much. Yeah, this is okay. Thank you so much for this. Definitely. So many other things to do, not only this, but we have to start somewhere.
Yeah.
And we highly encourage any other organization to do anything, to work on investment, to work on increasing the number of children also here, helping the kids, helping the families so that they can have more kids, helping people in villages. Definitely, there's a lot of work that needs to be done. We are working on this, and we are hoping that in the future, or now even, someone else will work on other issues. Thank you, Eddie. Okay, how can I help? This is the second time that I posted. I think Father Hamoun will be talking now. But after that, no, go ahead. Who will be? Meeting time. Okay, so we will be now meeting. Yes, now. So how can I have those now? Yes. Meeting the US people and the people from Canada, France, Spain, and the UK come with us. Father Hanoum will take the people